Okay, so our story that we're going to act out is with this little guy. Look at Do you know who he is? This is a silly little guy. His name is Rumpelstiltskin. Do you know that story? We're going to change it a little. We're going to do some dancing. I need your help. Because he is going to help out this girl. Do you see her? She is going to be a girl in our story. We'll do that at the end. Oh, here comes Caitlin. All right, let me mark down who's here. Margaret's here. Meredith. Hi, Caitlin. Ronan, Ruby. Emmy is sick today. We'll send her lots of well wishes. How are you, Caitlin?
Good.
Hey, we were talking about our favorite movies. Do you have a favorite movie?
Yeah.
What is it?
Elf, Frozen 2.
Oh, my goodness. Just like Margaret and Meredith. Okay, well, we're going to go ahead and get started. Maybe some of our friends will join us. So stand up and back up into your space so that you have some space around you. Move and groove. I'm going to put us all on mute so we don't hear all the background noises. Okay. Oh, here comes Lydia. Just in time. All right. Hey, let's do our waiting for the elevator warm-up. We haven't done that in a couple weeks. So have a spot that's going to be your elevator that we'll come back to every time. And then follow me. Remember, we're also going to work on our musicality. So we will tap our knees to the beat. We'll tap our head to the beat. We'll tap our shoulders. And then we'll clap. And then we'll try to do one of each, which is knees, head, shoulders, clap. Can you guys say that with me? Knees, head, shoulders, clap. Good. Okay, and then we're going to act like some animals. Hi, Lydia. How are you today? Happy to see you. All right, have a seat on your elevator, dancers. I'll get mine.
Then you come and jump with me.
Good job. Hey, Caitlin. Yeah, I was going to say, angle your screen down just a little bit. That way I can see your whole body. All right, let's do I'm going to catch you. Do you think I can catch you through the screen? No? I'll try, okay? Here we go. All right. Oh, why don't we move our elevator out of the way? If you have like a blanket or a pillow or something, just move it out of the way so you don't trip. There we go. You're moving it, Ruby. Good job. All right, stand in first position. And every time it says jump on in to Monday or Tuesday, whatever day it is, remember when you do your saute, let me see a good demi-plie. And then saute and glue those heels back together every time, okay? Here we go, dancers.
I'm gonna catch you, you better run. I'm gonna catch you, you
better jump into Monday.
I jump into Monday. And I had an ice cream sundae.
Ice cream sundae. Oh, yummy. Wow.
But then I turned around and heard a sound.
My shot there goes.
Catch you, you better run. I'm gonna catch you, here I come.
Jump in the Tuesday, heels together.
Tuesday. Had myself a Tuesday.
Hello, everybody. Hi. I'm gonna get you, Ruby! Can I get you, Lydia? Can I get you, Caitlin? Here I come, Margaret, Meredith. All right, everybody pose in your best era best. Ready? Get line behind you. And then you can lift your leg. Ready? Point your toes hard. Make that leg stick straight.
Welcome to the farm.
Good job, everybody. All right, hey, listen. If you point your toes and stretch your leg in your arabesque, it will really help you to balance. Can I see it on the other side? We have to be good at our, on both sides with our arabesque. Don't lift your leg until I say, ready? Put that leg behind your dear ear. Now look how straight my knee is. Don't let your knee have a bend in it. Stretch it. Show me, Ruby. Okay, zip up your tummies. Arms are nice and straight. Remember, this arm is to the side. It's not behind you. Shoulders down, don't lift it yet. We're gonna lift it all together and we're gonna balance. We're gonna hold it for three counts. You're gonna fight for it, are you ready? Margaret, Meredith, I'm waiting for you. Get that knee really straight, Lydia. Stretch your leg really straight. Ready, on the count of three, we're gonna lift. Come on, do it with us, please. One, two, three, hold it. One, two, three, fight for it, yes, good job. That was awesome. I noticed a couple things. Ronan, that was awesome. I saw that you felt like you were gonna lose your balance, so you just put your toe down and then you tried again and then you held it. That was amazing. Really well done. Okay, let's go ahead and move on. And let's do If You're Happy and You Know It, and then we'll go into our teapot dance. All right, ready?
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Margaret, Meredith, beautiful. Good job, Ruby. Caitlin, I can't see your feet, sweetheart. Can you angle your camera down just a tiny bit? Maybe just a little? All right, let's dip our toes in some water, ready? Let's open up one arm to the side. Watch that hand. Open the other arm. Round your arms like you're holding a really big beach ball. Oh, I have an idea. Hold up. Your body, okay? position, right? And then my arms grow. Oh, and now I'm second position. Is that kind of funny? All right, let's try to do it on the other side. Tandu, put your heel down. Show me your second position. Are you ready?
Hold on, I'm afraid it's gonna go into our popcorn, huh?
Here we go. Arms wide. Uh-oh, get out of my way. Here we go. Wash, wash, wash the floor. Wash the floor some more. Wash, wash, wash the floor. Now make sure you're on the other side. Tandu, show me that beautiful pointed toe and your straight knee. Ready, make the number. Uh-oh, I'm gonna change the arms on you. Four. Put your arms up to fifth. Fifth position, arms, good. Whoa, I see that some of you have awesome balance. Ruby, I think you can stay there all day long. It's awesome. All right, and open. Good job. All right, let's be a piece of popcorn. Go into a little tiny kernel. Ready?
You put the oil in the pot and you let it get hot. You put the popcorn in and you start to grin.
Lydia, that's amazing. Good job. Oh, I see mom's toes too. Good job, mom. Oh, no tunnels, Ronan. Open up or bring those legs flat, sweetie. Point those awesome feet of yours. Point them. Oh, wow, that's amazing. Let's see, Ruby. Good job, you're doing it. What? Look at Ruby with her sisters. You guys look amazing. Look at those toes. Caitlin, I think you're in there somewhere, but I can't see your toes. I see a cute picture on your wall. I think that screen is just angled up a little high. But I know Caitlin, she has amazing feet and legs. She is a strong girl. All right, tickle all the way down to those toes. Flex your toes and pull them back. Let me see, can you do that? Pull your nose to your, or your toes to your nose, yeah. Let me see, who can reach your toes? Meredith, can you reach them? Let me see. Oh, hold them. Can you pull your toes back? Look, Lydia's doing it. Good. Ronan, you guys are getting so flexible.
I can't see Caitlin. I can see the top of her forehead. Oh, good job. All right, here we go. All right. are you guys ready for a fun story? I have a really fun story for us today. It involves a funny looking little man. Do you want to see what he looks like? I showed a couple of you at the beginning of class. This is him. Guess what his name is? His name is Rumpelstiltskin. That's a weird name, isn't it? So, I will tell you all about it, but try to remember his name if you can. You'll need it for the end of our story. Okay. So, let me find some good story-like music, and we will start at the top of our story. But I need your help to tell the story because there is a really special part where we need to dance in this story. Okay, so our story begins. All my little characters here. Okay. Once upon a time, there was a man, and he was a miller. And he did not have a lot of money. And he was walking down the road one day, and he was thinking to himself, boy, if I had some money and some riches, I think my life would be better. Just then, along came a king riding on a horse. You ride on a horse with me? All right, get up. We got to gallop on a horse. Ready? Go.
Gallop on a horse. Gallop, gallop, gallop.
Good job. Okay. So the king is riding on a horse. He's galloping around his kingdom, and he meets this nice older gentleman. And he says, "Stop, king, stop. I want to tell you something really important. I have a beautiful daughter. And she has a special talent." And the king says, "Oh yes, what is her talent?" And he says, "She is a ballet dancer. And she is the most beautiful dancer in all the land. When she dances, magical things happen." And the king says, "Tell me more about this magic that your beautiful dancing daughter has." And he says, "Well, when she dances on a pile of hay, it turns into gold." And the king says, "What? I don't even believe this. I have to see this for myself." And so the old man calls his daughter, and she comes out and she says, "Hello, father." And he tells the king, or he tells his daughter, that he already told the king about her special, beautiful dancing talent, of how she can turn hay into gold. And so the king says, "Well, you're going to come with me to my kingdom, and we'll see if what your father says is true. And if it is true, I will give your father some of that gold." So the girl follows the king, but secretly, guess what? She is worried because she doesn't know what her father is talking about. Of course she loves to dance, and she's danced ballet since she was a very little girl, but she's never really made any hay or straw into gold. So the king locks her in a room and says, "You can come out when all of this hay has been turned into gold." And she has a pile of hay. Oh, she sits down and she's so sad. She starts crying. Show me how you would cry if you were her. She starts crying. And just then appears a very funny looking man. And his name is Rumpelstiltskin, but he does not tell her his name. He just says, "Oh, pretty girl, why are you crying?" And she explains her dilemma. She says, "Well, the king thinks that I can turn this whole pile of hay into gold by dancing on it. And I just don't see how I can do that." Well, Rumpelstiltskin says, "I have magic powers and I can turn that hay into gold. What will you give me?" And she says, "Well,
I have a necklace. I could give you my necklace. And he says, okay, well, let's see. And he stands up and he stands next to the pile of hay and he does a little dance. Okay, now let me teach you the little dance because I need you to do this with me, okay? So stand up. Okay, so here is his little dance. This is how he turns the hay into gold, okay? He's gonna round his arms and glue his feet together. And of course, he knows ballet too, right? And he is gonna do four little sautés in first. Do it with me and count, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then he's gonna do four sautés in second. 1, see how wide my feet are? 2, 3, 4. And then he's gonna do an échappé. In and out, again. In and out, the third time is different. In and up, and soupané. And then he opens his arms and uses his magic powers. And then let's see if we can turn that hay into gold. Can you do it with me? We have to do it two times. Four sautés in first, four sautés in second. Our arms match our legs. In and out, in and out, in and up, and soutenu. We do that two times. Here we go. Glue those heels together, dancers. Let's turn this hay into gold. Ready? One. Wait, hold on. Let me turn this up so we can all hear it. Here we go. This is his song. Ready? One, two, three, four. Second. One, two, three, four. In and out. In and out. In. Now in and out. In and up. And soon. One more time. One, two, three, four. Second. Get those knees really bent. Exactly it. In and out. Looks at that hay, he sprinkles his magic powers on it, and ta-da! Look what happened. Yay, you guys helped us turn the hay into gold. Well, the girl, the pretty girl, she cannot even believe her eyes. She says, how in the world did you do that? You must be magical. So she gives the funny little man her necklace. And he says, thank you. And he runs away. Well, can you imagine when the king sees all of the riches and the gold that she danced into? She danced that hay right into gold. So of course he is so excited. He gives some of the gold to the poor father. And then the next day, he says, okay, since you have these magic powers, I am going to give you more hay to dance into gold. And the girl is so surprised because she thought maybe she was done. So show me a surprise face. Oh, she's so surprised. Oh, good, it's a good surprise face, Ruby. Oh, okay, so he puts her in another room with even more hay. And she starts crying. Cry again with me, ready? And then, guess who appears again? Dun, dun, dun. That funny little man. And he says, why are you crying, pretty girl? And she says, well, you helped me so much. You turned that hay into gold, but now the king has given me more hay. And I still don't know how you did it. I mean, of course I can dance and do sautés and échappés, but I don't know how I'm gonna turn this into gold. So he says, well, if I do it again for you, what will you give me? And she says, well, all I really have left is this beautiful ring. This ring. Will you take my ring and help me one more time? And he says, oh, okay. Does everybody
Let's help him. Ready? Stand up. Let's do it one more time. Are you ready? Do you remember our dance? Here we go. Ready? First position. Ready? Go. One, high, two, three, four. Hey, shuffle. Okay. I'm going in. I'm sorry. I got a little distracted. I saw Nora Ann. Try it again. Ready? Four sautés. One, two, three, four. Now jump to second. Two, three, four. In and out. In and out. In and out, and sit to new. One more time, go. One, two, hold your arms. Three, four, second. One, two, three. Now in and out. Now in and out, and sit to new. All right, sprinkle your magic powers
on that pile of hay. Can you help me? Sprinkle it on there. Sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle. All right, let's see if we were magic. Ta-da! You did it. Thank you for helping. You did it one more time. Well, of course, you know, the girl, she is so surprised that he was able to help her once again. So he says, goodbye. He goes away. And then the king, oh, he's so surprised. One more time, show me that surprised face. Oh, he did it again. Or she did it again. He doesn't know that she has that little helper. And look at all the gold. So he says, okay, well, this is the biggest trick of all. I am giving you even more hay. This time, if you turn it all into gold, I will make you my queen. And he goes away. And it gives her even more straw this time. Even more, a whole room full. Well, she is so sad because she doesn't know really how to turn this hay into gold. So she starts crying again. And then who do you think appears? That funny little man. And he says, let me guess, you need my help again. She says, yes, I do. Well, what do you have to give me? I have nothing. I have nothing to give you, funny little man. But the king said that if I turn this pile of hay into gold, I will become his queen. So I can give you all the riches in the world. He says, no, I don't want any riches. What I want is your firstborn baby. And she thinks, well, you know, I don't think he's gonna really do that, but I do need to get out of this dilemma. So she agrees and she says, okay. So for the third time, he does his little dance to turn that hay into gold. Okay, help me one last time. Are you ready? Stand up. All right, heels together. First position. Ready? One, two, three, four. Jump to second. Six, seven, eight. In and out. In and out. In and out. In and out. In. Up and around the bay. And two, last time. Go. One, two, three, four, jump wide, five, six, point those toes, and those knees, in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out, and suit to new, and let's see, sprinkle your magic powers on the hay, sprinkle it, let's see if you could do it a third time. Oh, he did it again, can you believe it? So guess what happened? The king is so happy. He does. He makes her his queen. And some time passes. Well, guess what? She has a cute little baby. And one night appears in the nursery. I think the baby's as big as she is. That little weird little man appears again and says, aha, you have had a baby. And that's what you promised me, to turn that hay into gold. And she says, oh, I didn't think you were serious. Please, please have mercy. Please don't take my baby. And he says, well, I will make you an offer if
And only if you can guess my name in the next 2 days, I will not take your baby. And he goes away laughing. Ha 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 ha. She will never guess my name because it is a strange name that nobody has ever heard of. And I never told her. So for 2 days straight, she is trying to remember if he ever told her his name. And she keeps thinking of all these weird names. She keeps thinking, well, is his name Frank? No. Is his name Joe? No. Is his name Snake Eyes? No. She keeps thinking of really odd names. Is his name Jemmy? No. Oh, I'm never gonna guess it, and then my baby is gonna go with that strange little man. Well, that night, the little man was out dancing by a fire, and there was a messenger of the king that happened to be passing by, and he hears the little man saying, "Today I brew, tomorrow I bake, and after that the child I'll take. Never can the queen guess that Rumpelstiltskin is my name." Well, the messenger runs back and tells the princess, "I know his name." So that night, the strange little man comes to the nursery and says, "All right, I'm ready to take your baby, unless, can you guess my name?" And she says, "I've been trying so hard to think of what it could be. Could it be Frank? No. Could it be Tom? No. Well, the only guess I have left is it Rumpelstiltskin?" And he says, "Yes, how do you know my name is Rumpelstiltskin?" And he's really mad. Show me a mad face. He's really mad. And he stomps his feet so hard. Stomp, stomp, stomp. Can you stomp your feet? Stomp, 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 stomp. And he stomps so hard that he goes into the floor. And she looks down and he is gone. Never to be seen again. Well, the king and the queen live happily ever after with their cute little baby. And the father, he also gets to move into the castle. The end. Yay! All right, did you guys like my silly story? All right, you did a good job helping me. Hey, it is time to finish. We're gonna finish with our little star dance, and then we're gonna curtsy and bow and say goodbye. And then next week, what do you guys think about, since it's our last class together, what do you think about maybe putting on our costumes and doing, at the very end of class, doing our dance in our costumes? Would you like to do that? I was thinking it might be fun. Okay, here, let me find our song. Back up into your room and then follow me. We'll turn our music up. Ready? Today. I had fun with you all.